स्ट्रक्चर एनालिसिस इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैड कंप्लीटेड ऑल द थियरी पोर्शन ऑफ दैट चैप्टर नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर एग्जांपल एक्सरसाइज लेट अस स्टार्ट विद अ सिंपल एग्जांपल एन एक्सियल पुल ऑफ 50 kN is suddenly applied to a steel bar which length is 2 meter and 1000 mm square in a cross section. Modulus of elasticity, which we are already studied in the mechanics of solid of steel, is 200 kN per mm square. Find first maximum instantaneous stress, second maximum instantaneous extension, third strain energy, and fourth modulus of resilience. We know all of this equation already solved from theory portion. Let first data P, load 50 kN, area 1000 mm square, L 2 meter is equal to 2000 mm, E 200 kN per mm square, converted into 200 into 10 raised to 3 newton per mm square. Okay. First, maximum instantaneous stress. It means stress. Equation of stress for maximum sigma is equal to 2P upon A. Put the value of P and A into this equation, we get 100 newton per mm square. Similarly, maximum instantaneous extension, we need to convert the word extension into elongation. Okay, that means the elongate distance of that bar. That's why we need to find eccentricity E is equal to delta upon epsilon is equal to epsilon is equal to delta upon E. Put the values of delta 100, E 2000 into 10 raised to 3, we get 5 into 10 raised to minus 4. Now we know that the strain is equal to delta L upon L. So we need to know delta L, pivot the delta L and put E epsilon into L, strain into length, 5 into 10 raised to minus 4 into 2000 is equal to 1 mm. The elongation is 1 mm, or we can say extension is 1 mm. Now, third portion is strain energy. U is equal to sigma square into 2E into V. It is the equation we already know, the theory portion. Put the value of variant equations, sigma square upon 2E into V, sigma is equal to 100 square, E is equal to 200 into 10 raised to 3, V is equal to volume we can length into area, we get volume, then U is equal to 15 newton into meter, it's also denoted by joule, pi modulus of resonance, U m is equal to sigma square divided by 2E, the value of sigma and E, we get 0.25 newton into mm cube. The unit are very important, because with the help of unit we can consider particular things, otherwise the thing is totally changed and the sum is go wrong also in real world. Now example 2. An unknown weight fall through 20 mm on her collar rigidly attached to the lower end of a vertical bar. 4 meter long and 25 meter in a diameter. If the maximum instantaneous extension is known to be 4 mm, what is the corresponding stress and the value of unknown weight? Take E is equal to 210 kilonewton per mm square or 210 into Pa. Okay. The example is quite similar to the December 2011, January, December, and similar to the June 2016. This is the most most easy example and valuable for the exam. Put the value D, 25 L, 4 meter, converted to into mm, 4 into 1000 is equal to 4000 mm, height 20 mm, sorry, H is equal to 20 mm, delta L, elongation is equal to 4 meter. Okay. We need to calculate area for bar. It is 490.87 through pi by 4 into D square . Let us simplify from the figure. Here we have figure 4.7 in which rod is connected to the collar and think P something collar drop through 20 mm height, total length 4 meter. Okay, we now get delta L is equal to sigma L upon E, but we have all the value and put it in this equation, we get sigma is equal to 210 newton into newton per mm square. Now work done is equal to energy stored. P into H plus delta L is equal to sigma square upon 2E into V. So P into 20, the value of H, delta L is equal to 4, and 210 upon 2 into 10, 210 into 10 raised to 3. And the volume of this bar, the length is 4000. And the area is 490.87 mm square. Now, from simplify it, we get P is equal to 8.59 kilo into meter. Now, another example, as same as it, a 1500 mm long wire of 25 mm square cross sectional area is hang vertically. It receives a sliding collar of 100 kilonewton weight and stopper at bottom end. The collar is allowed to fall on stopper through 200 mm height. Determine the instantaneous stress induced in the wire and corresponding elongation. Also determine the strain energy stored in the wire. Take modulus of elasticity of wire as 2000 gigapascal. Okay. These are the same example as we previous solved in example 2. So that I want you guys are going to try this example as your homework example, and give me the results. Okay, in case of any query or difficulty, let me inform. So without wasting our time, we are going to start a new example which vertical tie rod fixed at top and consists of steel rod 2.5 meter long and 20 mm diameter encased throughout in a brass tube of 20 mm internal diameter and 30 mm external diameter. The rod and the casing are fixed together at both ends. The compound rod is suddenly loaded in tension by a weight of 10 kN falling freely through 3 mm before being arrested by the tie. Calculate the maximum stress in each material. Take ES 200 GPa and EB 100 giga. S 10 for steel and B 10 for brass. Now we can first calculate the areas before going to solution. Simplify the figure. Here a steel rod which 20 mm diameter cover with brass tube which 30 and inner diameter is 20. Load is P 10 kN from the height 3 mm and the total length of the bar is 2.5 meter. Okay. AS is equal to pi by 4 D square is equal to 314.15 mm square, the area of steel bar. As same as for AB, there is a difference calculated and we can get the total area of brass, which is 392.70 mm square. As I say, S 10 for steel and B 10 for brass. Now go to the composite section. Sigma S upon ES is equal to sigma B upon EB, because we can consider epsilon 1 is equal to epsilon 2. Now sigma S is equal to ES upon BS, EB into sigma B. Put the values of each component, we can get sigma S is equal to 2 into sigma B. Now P, total load is equal to load on steel and load of brass. So put the value P is equal to sigma S into AS plus sigma B is into sigma B into, because we can know that the sigma is equal to P by A. Okay. So as we know, load 10 kN, 10 into 10 raised to 3 converted into Newton, 2 into sigma B, sigma S value from this equation 314.15 plus sigma B is equal to into 392.70, which is its area. To simplify it, we can get sigma B is equal to 9.79 Newton per mm square, and put this value in this equation. We can also find the sigma S is equal to 19.58 Newton per mm square. Now, important factor I is equal to 1 plus under root of 1 plus 2 into height divided by delta ST, where delta ST is static deformation, which is steel and brass have a same value. Now, for the steel, delta ST is equal to sigma S into L upon ES. Put this value of sigma S, L and ES, we can find delta ST is equal to 0.245. Similarly, we can say that in brass section, sigma ST is also 0.245. Okay, now put this value into above equation, we can get 6.05, which are important factor. The maximum dynamic force is 6.05 times the corresponding static from the maximum stress will be sigma s maximum 6.05 into 19.58 is equal to 118.46 Newton per mm square, and sigma b is equal to 59.22 mm square. Okay, so do that sum and we complete our syllabus up to here at this moment. Further, we can consider in a next lecture.